Where is the legislator who will courageously rise up to protect every single preborn baby in our state? We are searching for Wilberforce. Our first video of Representative Erin Grall included many of her statements where she acknowledged that abortion is murder and a horrible offense against every baby under her jurisdiction. I remember the image her words left in my mind when she said that she was very disturbed by the fact that these little babies are incapable of crying out for their own justice on the steps of the Capitol in Tallahassee. She explained how her dismemberment bill of 2 years ago didn't truly represent her convictions because it excluded countless numbers of children vulnerable to murder by other means. So why hasn't she filed a bill of abolition? Because she's listening to ungodly counsel. Representative Grall filed the Parental Consent Bill for the 2019 session, and now again for the 2020 session. She and her advisors are hoping to use this bill to weaken the existing privacy clause in medical legislation. Representative Grall, you've only been given a short time to fight as legislator in the House. You're trusting in the schemes and cunning of men. Man is faulty and frail. Jeremiah 17:5 says, "Thus says the Lord, cursed is the man who trusts in man and makes flesh his strength, whose strength turns away from the Lord." Psalm 44:3 says, "For not by their sword did they win the land, nor did their own arm save them, but your right hand, O God, and your arm, and the light of your face, for you delighted in them." But how will he delight in us as long as we continue to file iniquitous decrees? Just like with your last term, you will not finish this term with the peace and joy that comes from obedience to the Lord. There is no peace in the middle ground. Duty is ours, the duty to trust the Lord, the duty to obey Him. In the Lord we place our hope. He will not let us be put to shame. If you won't fight for our youngest babies on the floor of the House this coming session, no other lawmaker will be fighting for them. You've been given the authority and the responsibility. What a shame it would be if you left your position as representative never having fought for what your conscience knows is right. It would be completely unacceptable if some victims of the sex trade were excluded from protective legislation. Why do we do this with defenseless babies in the womb? The hypocrisy is sickening. Abortion legislation that does not define the preborn as persons, that does not define abortion as murder, and that does not provide protection for every single baby from conception is unjust legislation. It's a waste of precious time and resources. It allows for the continuation of legalized murder, and it communicates to our culture that providing justice for these victims of premeditated murder by abortion is not our first priority. Working within the parameter of the privacy clause is unnecessary. Abortion must be treated like every other crime listed in the murder statutes. You've been given the understanding, the courage, and the eloquence to fight for the people in this sector of society. Please don't squander those gifts on compromised legislation. It's unjust and irresponsible of the Florida Legislature to let those innocent persons go unspoken for and unrecognized in this upcoming session. Even if your colleagues in the House refuse to hear or pass the bill, at least you would have done what you know is right. Our culture needs warriors who will speak up and fight for truth. If your parental consent bill passes, you will be praised for your work and your gift of persuasion, but God will not be pleased by it. Be a friend of God by being a friend of our preborn babies, even if it means being an enemy of the world. Join with other abolitionists around the nation who have boldly taken on this holy task. We're tired of this battle. We acknowledge our guilt before God. How can we get out of this mess? But by turning from it with all of our hearts. Please repeal your parental consent bill and replace it with a bill of total abolition. The legalized bloodshed of innocent persons must be put to a stop. Now.